Hello, welcome to this how-to video on setting up iFIX to work with Historian and how they integrate together. So to get going, the first thing of course that you'll need to do is install Historian on a machine, either the same machine as your iFIX node or on a separate machine of its own, and you'll have the ability to reference that from an iFIX node. Once you've got Historian up and running, you'll need to, on the iFIX node, install from the Historian DVD the Proficy Historian client tools, followed by the iFIX collector from that same installation. Once you have those pieces installed, the next step is to get the Historian iFIX collector running on your iFIX node so that it can start collecting data and that you can configure the points you want to collect data from. So to do that, there's a couple of things that you can do. To get up and going, the easiest thing is to go ahead and just search for iFIX. And if you search for that, you'll find there's a start iFIX collector that gets installed. This is a batch file. If you run it, you can see that it starts it in a UI mode. And so now with this running, and I'll show you subsequently how to set that up to run every time you start iFIX, you would want to go into the administration panel and in the Configure Historian dropdown, select Configure Historian. You can see that when I installed the Historian tools, and this should be the case for you as well, it will ask you for your Historian server, so it has set that up for default. If not, you can go ahead and add the server here and make it the default server. Down at the bottom of the dialog, you can see a setup for the collector. So if you hit Get Collectors, because the collector is running, we can select it and set it as the default. So that sets up the connection between the collector and the Historian that you're collecting to. If you want to just take a quick look at the Historian, wherever it's running, you can actually pull it up from the Historian Administrator button. And you can see that we have our iFIX collector running here. If you go and look at the tags and try to find any tags belonging to that collector, nothing is there yet. So we'll just leave that for now. So the easiest way to get up and collecting iFIX points is to actually go to the database, select the point you want to connect to and collect, and go to the Historian tab here. In here, there's a number of different options that you can explore in the help, but simply put, you can go ahead and select Enabled and start collecting the point values from this point to the Historian you just configured. So if I save that, put that on scan, that point is now collecting to Historian at that 5-second rate that it's configured to. To check that, you can go back to the administration tab and go to the Historian administrator, go to the tags again, search the tag database for all of the iFIX collector tags, and you'll see that tag shows up here. If I look quickly, I want to just see the values that it's collecting. You can see that we're collecting data from that ramping value in the iFIX database. So simply enabling the points you want to talk to Historian starts to create that collection interval. Final thing I'd like to share with you is just the way in which you would want to make sure that your collector runs all the time without having for you to run it manually yourself, would be to go into the configuration task configuration tab in the SCU. When the collector is installed, it installs itself in the iFIX install directory. So you can see we have an iFIX collector.exe. So if I grab the path to that and I want to create a new command line or new task, I can copy that, go back over here, collect that name. And then finally, one thing that you'll want to do is go ahead and use a command line of run as DOS so that it runs silently and when you run this task. So run as DOS and runs in the background. So once you do that and you restart iFIX, it will start collecting as soon as it comes up. Simple, right? Thanks for watching, and hope you tune into our other videos on our SCADA products as well.